In politics, when you peak is key, which means this weekend is crucial for all the GOP Senate candidates hoping to convince voters to support them next Tuesday. Good evening. I'm Natalie Glucklich.
And I'm Todd Andrews. The latest poll numbers show the Republican race for Ben Nelson's Senate seat is getting closer by the day.
The survey conducted by the Singularis Group last Sunday of 400 likely Republican primary voters shows John Bruning in the lead with 29.8%, followed by Deb Fischer with 25.6%, and then Don Stenberg and Pat Flynn. The margin of error is 4.9%.
KETV News Watch 7's Amanda Crawford caught up with the candidates today. She's live with tonight's Commitment 2012 report.
Guys, each candidate is logging lots of miles, visiting lots of neighborhoods, hoping to win over Nebraskans' votes before the primary next Tuesday. We talked to candidates about the latest polls, ads, and their most important message.
It's 4 days before the Nebraska primary, and it's crunch time for the candidates. We caught up with Don Stenberg as he visited with voters in Fremont.
John Bruning's support is dropping quite dramatically. I think a lot of the undecideds are going to be moving our direction in the last days of the election.
John Bruning was campaigning in western Nebraska and talked to us by phone.
Well, we always expected that it would close. We didn't think we were ever going to win by 30 points. You know, it's one of those things, kind of a natural law of politics.
But the wild card in this race could be State Senator Deb Fischer.
Our ads up on TV are very positive. And I believe that that's what Nebraskans want, and that's what they're responding to.
This week, Sarah Palin endorsed Fischer.
Maybe some of the comments since then that have been negative and, I believe, rather desperate are a result of the great endorsements that I'm getting.
But the other two candidates don't think that's a game changer.
We've just got a very broad-based coalition of support, so I take my endorsements over those any day.
Mike Huckabee and Rick Santorum have both backed John Bruning, while Stenberg says he's proud to have names like Jim DeMint and Rand Paul behind him.
And they're the people that are on the ground in the Senate fighting the battle, and they're the people that I'll be working with.
Out here on the road, each candidate says they're focusing on driving home a very specific message to voters in these last few days.
It's going to be to reduce the size and scope of government.
Don Stenberg's the genuine lifelong conservative.
I'm known as a tax cutter.
Each candidate says they'll be hitting the road this weekend again, talking to more voters across Nebraska. Coming up at 6, we'll talk to all three of those candidates about the latest television ads out this week.
All right, Amanda Crawford reporting live. Thanks very much. Remember, you can always find more.